here we are in
John's garage.
John's garage. John's garage in Northwest Arkansas, and we're finishing up on Mag 40. And
day three. Yeah.
Day three of Mag 40 at the Nighthawk Custom Firearms Training Facility. And just three instructors. I'm Don.
Tracy.
Chaz.
Yeah. And we were just going to chat a little bit about the experience here and what's been going on and what we think of the whole thing. So, Tracy, never at a loss for words. What do you have much to say about how we've been doing here?
I think we've been doing great, Don. Mm-hmm. I wish we had more women.
Yeah, what's that all about?
Last year, I took 40 here, this time last year, and we had 7 women in the class, and it was great. Jody's wife was one of our students. Mm-hmm. She was our most improved shooter. I came back for Magic, the only woman. I came back for Mag 30, the only woman. And here we are. So I've got to figure out how we get women in more advanced firearms training classes.
Now you actually do some firearms training with women, don't you, Ben?
I do. I am a state of Texas concealed handgun license instructor. I don't really like to teach that. I'd rather teach people how to run their gun mm-hmm. than teach them all the legalese about when mm-hmm. and where and those sorts of things. I'm a staff instructor at KR Training. Mm-hmm. I'm a staff instructor at a local gun range in Austin. Private instruction. Mm-hmm. I shoot on a girl and a gun women shooting league. I shoot IDPA. Mm-hmm. I do it all.
So there are women involved in the shooting sports.
Yes.
Yeah, but they're not here.
No.
Yeah.
So that's
frustration.
I'm going to work on remedying that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, and at the when we did Mag 120 in Indiana, we did a video about that with Gail Pepin.
A good shooter in her own right.
Absolutely.
Excellent. Yeah. Evil Princess is accurate. Yes.
Talking about women and the role of women in firearms, and of course she's a big proponent of that. And it's amazing women shoot very well.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't mean that from it's an amazing that they jump that they shoot very well, but it's amazing that they're not more involved because they shoot so well.
I've asked a couple of my mentors before, why don't we see more women shooters?
Mm-hmm.
I've gotten answers about women are more interested in spending money on their families and not on themselves. If you look at it from a perspective of being able to defend your family, mm-hmm. I'm going to call bullshit mm-hmm. on not spending money for that training.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I have heard that there is the woman pack mentality. Women can't go to the bathroom by themselves. Women can't go take handgun training classes by themselves. Either I'm an anomaly and freak of nature, or I am incredibly out of the bell curve. Mm. I don't get it. I think there's a huge untapped market.
Mm. I think I'm green, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I know back in Pennsylvania, where I live, I'm known in and around the area as somebody to go to for instruction and discussion about these kind of things. And I constantly have women coming up and saying, you know, I'd really like to do this. And I said, well, that's great. Let's set up a time. Well, I got to check this. I got to check that. And I said, well, okay. If you feel more comfortable, grab a friend and let's just go shooting and forget about instruction first. Let me just take you shooting and show you what that's all about. And I've found that that's a great introduction for many people, many of the women, to just kind of get started. Chaz, what have you been running into with... Well, first of all, how are you enjoying the MAG instruction here at MAG 40 so far?
It's pretty darn excellent. So I've been impressed. This is the first time I've had Tracy as one of my assistant instructors with John.
Mm-hmm.
He's doing a great job. and she makes a great sandwich as well as a great shooter. She knows her 15 grain breads and deli meats. On
the special pickles,
coffees come hot and fresh every morning, so it's been pretty impressive. So Tracy has definitely held her own. I call her Bex.
Bex. That's with an X.
Bex.
Beck, as in Becker. My name,
Becker
Tracy
Tex.
Becker Thronberg.
Right. From Texas.
I hadn't thought we hadn't gotten there with that part. It hadn't evolved into that yet,
Bex
Doc.
From Tex.
Yeah. Yeah, that's for Dex.
Yeah.
That is good. Yeah.
So you've enjoyed the training, and any comments about the overall training and how the students have progressed and those kind of things?
Well, there's one or two that are struggling, and they're coming along just fine, but when you get to people actually care about firearms training and their own personal protection, you generally get people that are willing and eager to learn. They don't come here and spend money because they expect to be catered to. But
were my instructor at the 40 last year.
Right.
Don, how did you wind up? Probably LFI. I know you had an LFI shirt at Magic.
Yeah.
So what got you to LFI 1? Let's turn the tables here. Let me ask you a couple of questions.
Oh, sure. Well, LFI 1 for me was back in 2000, and I had at that point a concealed carry permit for 18 years from 1982 to 92, 18 years, that adds up.
I'm sorry, what year?
82.
Okay, I was 11. Nice.
And, I never thought too much about it. I mean, I had the concealed carry permit. I rarely took the gun with me anywhere. And then as things moved along, I thought, I really should know what I'm doing. So I started to snoop around and say, well, if I was going to get trained anywhere, where would I go? And there were a couple of local shops or this guy that you could go to. But then I thought, well, this actually looks pretty interesting. The Massad, back then it was the Lethal Force Institute, and they were holding a class, the LFI 1, in Pittsburgh, which is not too far from me. So I took the 5 days and went down there, and I would have actually I got the most improved shooter for that class, not because I was so good by the time I was done, but I really sucked when I got it. I just the bottom.
So you truly were
The bottom was there. I mean, I came in with a little pocket pistol, and I did have a backup.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say flintlock. I'm sorry. I had a
flintlock. Yeah, two stones. A bola. But I had one of these little pocket pistols.
A blunderbuss.
I really didn't know much about it. And so from there it was LFI 2, LFI 3, MAG 120, because by then LFI had moved on, and then other training academies and so forth. So it was the right thing to do, I think, for caring. And if you're going to... I've said this before to many folks that the thing that impressed me most about LFI 1 and would be the equivalent of MAG 40 now is I actually came away feeling a little uncomfortable. And I was glad that I did that, because if I had gone to a program where someone said, just shoot them and let God sort it out, you'll feel great after you defend your family, didn't make me really see the gravity, as in the gravest extreme, the gravity of what I was doing, I don't think I would have taken it seriously, and I wouldn't have pursued it the way that I have. So for me, that whole experience of coming back, being a little bit unsettled about all I had learned, because this what differentiates, in my opinion, these MAG programs from your standard shooting is it is manual of arms, it is a skill level, but it's also physiology. It's also psychology. It's also law. It's also attitude. It's the whole ball of wax, and it's post-shooting aftermath, dealing with that system, and you don't get that anywhere else. So that's kind of why I went with this.
Jazz, how did you wind up at a 40?
Well, funny you should ask. I actually just got my concealed carry permit about 5 years ago. On October 1st, actually, is when it was issued.
So we're almost at, we're at an anniversary, yes.
5 years ago. And when you get the permit, so if you're a thoughtful person and you actually consider the gravity of what you're doing and carrying a piece of equipment on your hip that enables you to wield the power of life and death, I wanted to actually figure out what the rules were for this and when you could actually use it or if you can actually use it, and read the book In the Graves Extreme by Massad Ayoob. So I had the tool of the internet to look it up on Google about Massad Ayoob, and found out that he had something called Mag 40, and I was like, wow, this guy's still alive, amazingly. And signed up for a class in Live Oak, Florida, went down there to where he lives, that's his kind of home turf down there, and took a Mag 40 class. So, and that just opened up an entire new can of worms, and I asked, when I went through the class, I was like, wow, this is pretty cool. You know, I think I would like to do firearms instruction. This is, I like guns, I like being with like-minded folks, I like being out on the range, I like eating fried shrimp at the Brown Lantern in Live Oak, Florida.
Salacious plug for
the Brown Lantern.
How many golden chickens?
I gave it 4 golden chickens. And it was just a community of people, and just felt good, it felt nice. And you meet some really high quality folks, and I'm just like, wow, this is awesome. I want to do this some more. So I asked Mass, do you know of anybody in Arkansas, that's where I live, and where I could maybe get in touch with somebody that can help me and be a mentor? And unfortunately, he gave me John Hottaway's number, and I gave him a call. He gave me a call back, and we talked for a good hour on the phone, and pretty soon.
Is that all?
Yeah.
Yeah, why? Well,
how'd you get away that fast?
Easy, yeah. Oh, nice.
I think myself up
better. The battery was dying, yes.
And so, I actually met him, not in Arkansas, but in Utah, at my second Mag 40 that I went to as a student. And he invited me to come help out with some of the his events. And so I've been an indentured servant for pretty much the last 4 years.
So we all come to this from different backgrounds.
Yeah, y'all don't know how I got here.
Okay. Go ahead.
Our viewers around the world have no idea.
How'd you get here?
Do you know how I got here? Do you know how I got here?
You told me you drove.
Well, I did, but that wasn't where I was going with this question. What led me to Massad Ayoob? My home is in Texas. I come from a long line of shooters and hunters and outdoorsmen and voracious readers. We read a whole lot in the Becker family. And I had always liked firearms. My father and I, I'm an only child, we bonded over firearms. And I would read every subscription that he gets to all a jillion different magazines. TV channels, stuff like that, TV shows. And it was quite fortuitous the way I wound up here. At our first annual ever A Girl and a Gun training conference in March of last year, they were, you know, raffles, and they gave away ARs, and they gave away shotguns and all kind of crap. And then they said, so now we're going to have a prize table. And, you know, holsters and scopes and blah, blah. And they went, and here is a gift certificate to any Massad Ayoob Group class that you want.
Sweet.
And I honestly think that there were maybe 5 of us in the whole auditorium of probably 150 women who had any clue in hell who Maz was. So, you know, everybody's clapping. Oh, so-and-so won a pistol. Oh, so-and-so won a shotgun. And they said, and now we're just going to start calling out numbers. And if your number is chosen, you get to choose a prize.
Pick of the table.
That's it. Mm-hmm. And fortuitously for me, they call my number first. Mm. And I'm at the back of the auditorium, and I just stand up and point and say, Massad Ayoob Group. Mm-hmm. And I'm like going, ah, 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 ah.
Did anybody even know?
A couple of people knew. And the lady who is a firearms instructor, who is a friend of mine that lives down in Del Rio, she was like, I can't believe it. Mm-hmm. And so I get back to my room and I call my dad and I'm like, I won tuition to Massad Ayoob. And so I was like, well, the tuition is covered. Where the hell am I going to go take this class? So I started doing a little homework, a little bit of research. I'm like, well, I live in Central Texas. I think Arkansas is a doable deal. Yeah. It's not too far from home. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to have to fly and check guns. It'll be a pretty drive. And I get here and find out it's the home for Nighthawk Custom Firearms. Arguably the best 1911s on the market. So I come a day early, and I take a tour of the factory. I show up for class the next day, already knowing how to run my gun. I left 4 or 5 days later knowing how to run my gun that much better. Mm-hmm. Decided that John Hodaway and I had a really good rapport, and that I was mesmerized by the great philosopher. You know, what can I say? All the stories that he had, you know.
I'm sorry, John?
The great philosophizer,
okay.
Yes.
Got it.
Mm-hmm. Which also, you know, Austin is the capital of microbrew beers in this neck of our woods. And there is a beer, a microbrew made in Austin that is called the philosophizer.
Did he like it?
I haven't brought any for him.
Okay.
Yeah, you can come to Texas and try it. And, you know, I liked it, and after our Mag 40, he said to a few of his select few favorites, or mm-hmm. good students, whatever, you want to refer to us as, from the Mag 40, that, hey, you know, we're going to have a Massad Ayoob Group Instructor Clinic. Mm-hmm. And showed up. Mm-hmm. Only woman. Mm-hmm. Took that. Mm-hmm. That's where I met David Malio. Mm-hmm. And said, John, you tell me what you need. And he's like, well, I need you to be here for the 40 and help run it. I'm like, sure. And then I get a phone call from John one morning on the way to work that says, Tracy, we're having this class called the MAG 30, mm-hmm. and you need to be here. Mm-hmm. And undoubtedly, that was the best class I ever took to improve my game as a shooter. We were the inaugural class. Mm-hmm. There were maybe 7 or 8 of us. The only woman. It was kind of shoot till you puke.
Mm-hmm. What did you say, 2,200 rounds in 3 days or something?
Yes,
like that?
And half of that round count was shot on day 3.
Oh, boy.
And it was the hottest weekend of this summer mm-hmm. in Arkansas. Mm-hmm. We were chasing shade under trees. I shot my first and only perfect 300. I am the only woman recipient of a Nighthawk Custom coin. Firearms Challenge coin. I am the only woman recipient of a signed $5 bill for beating David Malio at Mag 30. And so I'm feeling pretty good about my game and my instruction. And
we're all here now passing that on to the new group of students that have come through. We've got
come see us.
15, and it's been fun, and we'll keep doing this.
Stay tuned for our next coming episode of, you know.
Sitting around and chatting on the leather couch.
Horns.